Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So today we will discuss the next point from our lesson, and what is the name of our lesson? Getting to know plants. So from that same lesson, now we will discuss about the leaf. So what is mean by the leaf? A leaf is a flat, thin, green lateral structure attached to the stem. It is also known as kitchen of the plant. Why it is known as kitchen of the plant? Because as we know, it makes the food for the plant. As it manufactures food with the help of chlorophyll present in them, that's why it is called as what? Kitchen of the plants. Okay, so now we will move for the next point, that is what we'll discuss about the parts of a leaf. Okay, parts of a leaf. So one by one we will discuss the all parts of leaf. So see here, I am having this one twig. Okay, so with the help of this twig we will discuss the different parts of a leaf. First one, a leaf grows on the stem at the node. So as we know, from which point the leaf grows? From the node. So the leaf grows at the node. Okay, the leaf grows on the stem at the node. So this is what node? So the point from where the new leaves arise, that point it is called as what? Bud. That we have already discussed. Next one, it is attached to the stem by means of stalk called petiole. Okay, so see here, it is attached to the stem. This is what? Stem. So the leaf is attached to the stem by the means of stalk. Okay, it is what? Stalk, or it is also called as what? Petiole. It is also called as what? Petiole. Okay, so what is the work, what is the function of that petiole? It helps to attach the leaf to the stem. So with the help of this petiole, the leaf get attached to the stem. Next one we'll discuss, that is the flat green part of the leaf. The flat green part of the leaf is called lamina or leaf blade. Okay, so this whole portion, this whole flat portion or whole green flat portion of the leaf is called as what? Lamina or leaf blade. It is called as what? Lamina or leaf blade. Next one we'll discuss, that the petiole continues. Okay, so see, this is petiole. So this petiole continues and forms the, or it runs through the center of the leaves, and it is called as what? Midrib. The petiole continues in the leaf as a thick midrib. Okay, see, I will turn it. So from the back side we will discuss. See here, if we'll see in the back side, then see here, this is what? Petiole. Okay, so this petioles runs, or it moves along the center of the leaves and forms what? Midrib. Okay, or we can say that vein which runs to the center of the leaf, it is called as what? Midrib. See here, it is what? Midrib. Okay, so what is mean by the midrib? It is the petiole which runs through the, or it elongated petinus continues to grow and it goes through the leaf, and that is only forms what? Midrib. Okay, the midrib on either side branches out. So see, you can see here, the midribs can, on the both the side, the midribs are having the branches. Okay, from both the sides, on either side means what? From the both the sides of the midribs get branch out, and that branches are called as what? Veins. Okay, so you can see here the network of the veins, that branches are called as what? Veins, to form a network. Okay, to form a network of veins. Okay, so this is midrib. It runs through the center of the leaf, it branch out at the both the side, and then it forms the veins, or it helps to form the network of veins. Okay, so now what we have discussed, we have discussed the different parts of leaf. What we have discussed in that? We have discussed that it is the node from where the new leaf arises, the flat lamina. This flat green color portion is called as what? Lamina or leaf blade. Next one, the petiole continues to grow and it forms the midrib. These midribs gets branch out, which is called as vein. Also, I want to show you one more thing. You can see here, one small growth is there. Okay, at the base of the leaf, you can see the small growth, and that small growth is only called as what? Auxiliary bud. Okay, this small bud, it is only called as what? Auxiliary bud. And what is its function? So as we know, this auxiliary bud helps to form a new branches, or these new branches are coming out from this auxiliary bud, which is situated in the base of the leaf on the stem, or it is in the between the stem and the base of the leaf. Okay. So this is about what? Auxiliary bird. Okay. Also we can say that this is this area or this boundary of the leaves, it is called as what? Margin. Okay. It is called as what? Margin. This border of the leaf, it is called as leaf margin. This is what? Stem. This is petiole. This is midrib. These are the veins. This whole portion called as lamina or leaf blade, and these are what? Leaf margin. Okay. So these are the different parts of a leaf. Now we'll see the next point, that is what? Venation. Now what is mean by venation? The arrangement of veins on leaf blade or lamina is called venation. Okay. The arrangement of the veins on the lamina or the leaf blade is called venation. So how the leaf, how the venation, how the veins are arranged on the leaf, that positions or that arrangement of the veins are called as what? Venation. So on the basis of that, there are the two types of the venation. The first one is what? Reticulate venation. So let's discuss the first definition. When the veins form a net like pattern on the lamina in the leaf, the venation is called reticulate venation. So what is mean by the reticulate venation? When the veins form a net like pattern, when the veins form the net like patterns on the lamina or in the leaf, the venation is called as what? Reticulate venation. So you see here, this is one leaf, and this leaf forms this net like structure of the vein. Okay. This is the network of the vein. We are watching from the back side also, we can see the from the front side also. So from the front side also, we can see this net like structure of the veins, and this net like structure only called as what? Reticulate venations. Okay. This type of, so these net like structure forms on the leaf blade or the lamina, then it is called as what? Which type of the venation? Reticulate venation. So in basically in the people, China rose, mustard, cabbage, lemon, neem, lychee, mango, so many are there who is having this reticulate venation. I am having one more example. See here, this is the leaf of, see here, this is the leaf of banyan tree. See, these are the side veins, and it also forms the network of the veins. From the front side also we will observe. See here, it is a network of the veins are there. Okay. And that is the reason it is which type of the venation? Reticulate venation. Okay. See, this whole portion is, whole leaf or lamina is having the network of the small vein, which is called as what? Reticulate venation. Now we'll see the next one, venation. Parallel venation. When the veins run parallel to the midrib or parallel to each other, the venation is called parallel venation. So the veins run parallel to the midrib. Okay, means they runs along the midrib, or they are parallel to the midrib. Then that type of the venation is called as what? Parallel venation. See, for example, we can see this banana plant. Okay. So this banana plant, you can see this venation. This is what? Midrib. And along with that, these are the side veins which are parallels to each other. Okay. Which are parallels to each other. Or we can say it doesn't form the network of the vein. Here also you can see from the back side, it don't have the network of the veins. All the veins are removed along the parallel. Okay. It doesn't have the network of the veins, then that type of the venation is called as what? Parallel venation. Okay. So this is what? Parallel venation. So this parallel venation, basically we can see into the banana plant. Also we can see in the sugar cane, palm trees, and in the bamboo plant. Okay. So in the bamboo plant and banana, sugar cane, and palm, there are the parallel venations. Okay. So now we have discussed about the venation, two types of the venation. This is the parallel venation, and this is what? Reticulate venation. Now we'll move for the next point.
So dear students, up till now we have discussed about the parts of a leaf, and also we have discussed about the venation. Okay. That are two types of the venation, reticulate venation and the parallel venation. But this reticulate venation and the parallel venation is having the relationship with the roots. So let's discuss the next point, that is relationship between the types of venation and types of roots. So see, if you want, as we know in our previous some videos, we have discussed about the types of root. There are the two types of the roots, that are fibrous root and the tap root. But is it possible to come to know which type of the roots are present in the plant without digging it out? Is it possible? Yes, it is possible to find out which type of the roots are present in the plant without uproot the plants from the soil. Okay, so for that, what we have to do? We have to observe the leaves of the plants properly. So if the leaves of a plant, are having the reticulate condition, then that plants are having the tap root. Okay, then that plants are having venation is parallel. If the plant is having the parallel venation, then that roots are, then the plant is having fibrous root. Okay, then the plant is having fibrous root. In this way, without uprooting the plant, we can come to know which type of the roots are present in the plant. If we will observe the plant and leaves of the plant, and if the venation is reticulate, then the plant is having tap root system. And if the venation is parallel, then the plant is having the fibrous root system. For example, we can see all the cereal crops are having this parallel venation, and that is the reason all the cereals are having the fibrous root. And for the tap root, we can say neem is there, mango, cashew nut, so many examples, etc., etc. We can say that, and all that plants are having reticulate venation with the tap root system. Okay, so this is all about today. And today's your homework is that you have to draw the diagram of parts of a leaf in your science notebook. This diagram is given on the page number 71 and the figure number is 7.70. This diagram you have to draw in your science notebook. Okay, so this is all about today.